students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding picking up the pieces in Nepal written by Rakesh Sood. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 1. Plus this is very important for geography optional students. Plus this is also important from your essay point of view. Plus this is also important for public administration optional students. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to look at the complete picture. We need to look at the disaster prone area of entire Asia. Now if we compare the regions of the world, what we see is that this entire South Asian region specifically is more prone to the natural disasters. The countries like Nepal, Bhutan, Myanmar, India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, they are more prone to these natural disasters. Now why they are more prone to natural disasters? It is because of the kind of the climate this region possesses. It is because of the huge anthropocentric pressure that this entire region is tackling. This region is also more vulnerable to the disasters because of the poverty of the governments. This region is also more vulnerable to the disasters because of the lack of the acumen, because of the lack of the human resource, because of the lack in the machinery, because of the lack in the technology to manage the disasters. So in the years to come, in the decades to come, this disaster management as a field, it is going to enlarge its scope. Disaster management as an activity is bound to increase in the years to come. So what really is required at this point of time? We need to fasten our laces. We need to be more proactive. We need to be more energizing ourselves in chalking down the policies for tackling the disasters. Now, what all needs to be done? There is a theoretical basis for how we can tackle about the disaster. There are techniques, there are ways by which the pre-disaster management should be done. There are ways by which the post-disaster management should be done. In the pre-disaster management, as far as the South Asian region is concerned, what we need to do is to prepare. Preparation is required and prevention is required. Now, out of this prevention and preparedness, prevention is something that is really tough. Now, why the prevention is tough? As I've already told you that this entire South Asian region, it has a lot of anthropocentric pressure. It is housing a good number of people. Bahut log rehte yahan pe, density of population bahut zyada hai. Uski wajah se jo humne policies design kiya hai, like we have designed the policies for urbanization, we have designed the policies for resource extractions, we have designed the policies for setting up industries. Now all these policies that we have designed, they are actually not in consonance with the nature. We are actually tinkering with the nature, and the tinkering with the nature generally results in backlashing, and this backlashing comes in the form of disasters. So if we want to prevent the disasters in the years to come, what we really need to do? We need to redesign our policies. We need to remold our policies. We need to resuscitate ourselves so that we can make ourselves more capable in preventing the disasters. Now the second thing in the pre-disaster phase is the preparedness. How we should prepare ourselves to manage this disaster. How the preparedness should be done? The preparedness is by generating the requisite technology, the requisite machinery, and the requisite human resource. And this entire thing should be मेड रियली रियली स्पेशलाइज्ड. Now, the kind of the cadre now presently we are having in India, or for that matter in Nepal, or in Sri Lanka, or in Pakistan, or in Myanmar, it is a generalistic kind of a cadre for the managing of the disasters. Now, disaster is something that will take place in an imminent manner. Now, it don't exist each day. It is something that will come once in a while. And because of its frequency of existing, of occurring just once in a while, puts the governments of all these regions in the state of procrastination, in the state of complacency. So we need to move out of the slumber and to work on this pre-preparedness phase, on this pre-disaster occurring phase. Then we've got the post-disaster occurrence phase. Now the post-disaster occurrence phase involves working on the response. Now in the response thing, what really matters is the speed, how we are able to tackle with the disaster once it has already striken. Then from response, there is a need to rehabilitate, how we can rehabilitate the people who have been affected by the disaster. Then at the end comes the mitigation, how we can mitigate the effects. Now this mitigation thing, it is party to both the phases, in the phase of the pre-occurrence and in the phase of post-occurrence. So we really need to prepare ourselves. We need to put into black and white about how the things should be done once the disaster has striken. Now, in order to gloss over our lacunas, in order to know about our lacunas, we really need to do the comparative study of how the Western countries, or for that matter, the Australia or New Zealand, how they manage whenever some earthquake strikes their nations. Now, an earthquake, it had striken the city of Christchurch in New Zealand 2 years back, and the entire thing was put in place in just a matter of 60 days. The human loss was taken care of, the property loss was taken care of, the structures were further constructed, and the policies for fighting it with the renewed energy was again set up in Christchurch. But the same thing is not happening here in Nepal. Now why it is not happening? It is because of the political kind of dissensions that are taking place in Nepal. Now as far as the Nepal is concerned, it has been almost 6 years that they have been fighting for of what type of the constitution should be there in their country. The constituent assembly has been elected twice. Two governmental elections had taken place in Nepal, but still they are in a state of quandary. They are still in a state of confusion. They are still in a state of dilemma. So, as far as the nature of the disaster management is concerned, it will not yield you the result if you're working in an environment, if you're working in a milieu, if you're working in an atmosphere where there is no political consensus, where there is no political consistency. So, what we have learned from this particular editorial is the need to create a strengthened political structure, because if you will have a fragile political structure, you will create fragile policies and you will create fragile disaster management mitigation system. So if you want to create a good disaster management system, you need to create good policies, and for good policies you need a strong political setup. You don't need a docile political setup. You don't need a political setup which is completely politicized. Development is something else, and politicizing the development is something else. We need to erase this politicization from the phenomena of development. And that till the time we will not be erasing this, it will not be possible to create structures, organizations, and human resource which will go in the field to tackle this disasters. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information on the classes that we are offering, you can visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.